So, as spring is just around the corner and potentially muddy season is going to happen, I have carpeted floors, so bringing your dogs in muddy is not an option. If they're just wet, we'll just use a towel to wipe their feet dry a bit, but if they are muddy, there is no other option than to give them a foot bath outside on the deck, of course, with warm water. It's too cold to have a hose running this time of year. So I thought it's a good idea to kind of refresh them on just basically putting two paws in a container, which is dry right now. But to start with, that's all I would do. Because I've had a dog in the past, I remember he would just kind of run for the hills, well, to the other side of the yard as soon as he saw me coming out with a bucket. And I thought, okay, I could pick my battles and put a leash on him and just kind of make him do it, or I could go turn this into a game and train him to put his paws in there on his own. And of course, that's what I did. So let's see what Hope wants to do. So we're just going to look at putting two paws in here. Maybe I'll do it from the side and reinforce that. Or maybe Jay wants to start. So my dogs have had a lot of practice putting their paws into something. If this is difficult for your dog, maybe just start with a little cardboard box. Okay. Releasing out. Yes. Good. You can reward when they have their feet in and then throw a cookie away to reset. Because we want to get that default where they just bounce back and I want my feet in there. I want my feet in there. This almost has to be stronger than standing in here. We can work a little bit on duration, that's fine. But we want a lot of this kind of coming back to us. Okay. When I have to reset, I'm going to try this with hind feet now. And that's okay, I can just bring them around, bring them forward. I don't, it's harder to aim for that. Really good. Good job. Good. I'm going to do a bit of duration. Release them out. And it's just by positioning it further away from me. There you go. Good. Good. So this tips over easily. We'll try something different. How about this one? This might actually be something that I could use. Just enough water to get the mud from within the toes. Get it. Try hind feet. Good. Hope is actually shaking. She can't wait for her turn. Good. So if your dog is already familiar and comfortable doing that, do you think it's going to be easier to wash their feet? Of course, adding water to this is another layer, which we're not going to do today, but it's a great preparation that they have this positive association when they see you coming out with a container instead of running away. They're just going to come running to it and let's say, okay, we're playing a game. Awesome. Get it. Good. So the next step would be to use the actual bucket that I do use for feet washing. So we're going to do this. It's a little hard to step in. Good. Stepping out. I'm going to hold it so it doesn't tip over and scare him. Good. Hope is livid. When is it my turn? Good. Good job. So I'm going to do a bit of handling while he's in there. Okay. Good thing it's empty. Get it. We can do a bit of pivoting, moving around. Just getting super comfortable having his feet in the bucket. Get it. I'm going to see if I can get him to do feet. Good job. Yes. Good. And it's okay if we can work with one foot at a time for the hind feet. That's fine. Yes.
Good job. Very good. So I'm going to do more rewarding in position here. It's great for body awareness. I'm going to try to release him over that way. Oops. Good job. There you go. Very nice. Good boy. Good. Go hop it up. All done. Get up on your bed. Good. So, that was a great session. We haven't done this for quite some time. Because in the winter, we don't need to do this. The next session will be outside. On the deck, on a different environment. And after that, I'm gonna add maybe a little bit of water to it and just kind of get them to go in and out without having to handle them. But maybe there's one more thing we can do here is, and that's a bit of handling while his feet are in a bucket. So I might have to pick up the foot and rub it a little bit because sometimes there's mud between the toes. Good. And then I might actually, you know, spray some water up his legs, up under the belly, all the while feeding. Good. Good job. Okay. Good. So now it's Hope's turn. She's a bit older, so I might help her a little bit more by, for example, holding the little container here. If your dog has never done anything like this before, I strongly advise to work with putting their feet onto something first, like starting with this, just getting the idea to interact with an object with their feet. So putting a paws on something that doesn't slide around. It could be a small box that's sturdy enough. And do this with front feet, then with hind feet. Lure them, help them, however they need to do it. And then progress to something, maybe a nice big box, just stepping through it. And just building that confidence that they are okay doing this before using. These things are slippery here, so we're not starting with the hard stuff. Hop. Good. So she's a little bit more cautious than Jay. I might hold it with one hand, make sure it doesn't tip. Good. That's actually okay if she does this and, you know, she knows she's, I'm in control, I'm doing this. She's okay with it. Releasing her away. Oh, there's your cookie. This can be a little different for an older dog. Good. She has never liked slippery surfaces, so just putting her paws in here, just putting one paw in here is okay. We can wash one paw at a time, no big deal. Good. Let's try the other one. See if we can get her to put the other one in. Oh, good. Both paws. Very nice. Good job. Good. I'm actually going to go to this one next. This one's more flat and she's more comfortable. It's a good idea to try different objects, different buckets and containers and see which one works best for your dog. Just pick your battles, you know. So one thing I can do here with this, I'm going to try to go for hind feet. I'm going to stabilize this with my legs. Get it. I'm always releasing her away from it so it's easy for her to come back towards me. Good job. Good. Good job. There we got one. Good girl. You always got to go at your dog's pace here. Good, she's okay. I can put one foot in there. I'm okay with that. Lots of rewards in position. Oops. We lost the bucket. Good. How about the other one? I know. So another thing to consider here is to practice this on a non-slip surface. So if you have hardwood floors or slippery floors, I wouldn't add slippery plastic containers to that, but use some sort of an area rug or something. We're just working on the dry step work here. So having a kind of a padded surface to do this on, there's these doormats. Oh, I think we just had two paws in there. I guess I was feeding too slow and she's kind of like, how about this? Okay, let's go. Two. Okay. Things fly around. Let's go to this one here. Hands are getting slobbery. No, I know. So I'm going to hold it. Job, yes. Good. I'm actually going to show you what I do with my dogs outside when we really have to do this for real. I'm actually going to just pick her up. Put her in here. Good. Can leave anytime she wants to. I'm gonna hold it so it doesn't fall over. But this bucket might be a little bit too high for her to step in, but it's just high enough that I can fill it about 3/4 and then we get most of those legs cleaned up and I can just splash some water under the belly and then afterwards towel dry them before we go in. Good. I think that was a good session. I hope you enjoyed this and check in for part 2 when we're going to take this outside and add some water. Okay, on to part 2 of washing feet. We're going to do this for real today. So, bucket's empty so far. We're going to start with this, putting your paws in. Good job. Very good. Out. Yes. Oh, he's kind of cautious. He knows usually this. Okay. Yes. Good. Okay. Yes. Good boy. Good job. Now we're just going to work. See if we can get hind feet. Can you step in there? Yes. Good job. It might be easier to do one hind foot at a time. It's all body targeting. Can you put that one in? Good. How about that one? Good job. Wow, super duper. Very nice. Okay, now release. So I'm just gonna put a little bit of water in here to start with. Over. Okay, how about now? Yeah, good job. Ooh, it's different. And it's not that he doesn't like water, like he's absolutely addicted to going in the tub in the summer. But a tub is not a bucket. Yes, what are you gonna do now? I want him to still choose to go in there. What a difference a little water makes, huh? Come on, get in there. And I can put them in there and just do it and he'll be fine, but I want to work a little bit more on his choice. What you gonna do? There's about this much water in there. No big deal. Huh? Come on. Yeah, good. You gonna do it for real? Yeah, good boy. Nice. Good job. One paw. We're very cautious here. Good. Okay. So. Now I'd like to pause. Come here. Huh? What about the other one? Oh, yeah, of course. I knew that had to happen. That's all right. We've got more. Good. Okay. Try to hold it. You're gonna have to put your feet in there. Come on, Jay. Amazing the difference this makes. Empty bucket versus an inch of water in there. And you're gonna have to put your foot inside. If it was a pool, he might already be in it. There you go. What else you got? Huh? Good. Come on. Get your feet inside. Come on. Get inside. Yes. Good. So he's 1 foot in, 1 foot out. Quick to flee. What else? So trying to coax it forward. Oh, very good. Nice job. Very nice. Good boy. So lots of feeding in position for this. Okay, see if we can replicate that. All right. You know what to do, buddy. Yes. 1 foot. 2 feet, good job. Believe it or not, I've actually never trained this with water. I usually just get it done. But I thought this year we're gonna train it better. What? Okay, I'm gonna release him one more time. We'll see if we can get back in quicker. Oh, here's the other one. Nice job. Oh, what a difference some treats make. Huh? Yes, good job. Wow. Okay. Okay. So I do need to wash him a little bit, so I'll kind of help the rest along. Well, I know. We got the hind feet already. More water. Yeah, you can do it. Yes, good job. Another one? Oh. Good. Good boy. Come on, put it in. Good. So what I'll do from here usually is a little bit of that belly. Oh, I know. Okay, I'm gonna finish off the hind feet here. I'll just put them in, wash off those legs. A little bit on the belly, and it's fine to do one at a time. There, maybe he feels safer that way. Good. Gabby. This way we can do a bit on that belly. And then I have to soak the tail usually. Good. So we have a sort of half decent clean dog. Now I just gotta towel him off and put him inside on a towel.